we as Americans have the capacity now, as we've had in the past, to do whatever needs to be done to preserve this last and greatest bastion of freedom. Government is not the solution to our problem. Government is the problem. We are a nation that has a government, not the other way around. And this makes us special among the nations of the earth. Our government has no power except that granted it by the people. From time to time, we've been tempted to believe that society has become too complex to be managed by self-rule, that government by an elite group is superior to government for, by, and of the people. But if no one among us is capable of governing himself, then who among us has the capacity to govern someone else? It's not my intention to do away with government. It is rather to make it work. Work with us, not over us. To stand by our side, not ride on our back. Government can and must provide opportunity, not smother it. Foster productivity, not stifle it. It is time for us to realize that we're too great a nation to limit ourselves to small dreams. Those who say that we're in a time when there are no heroes, they just don't know where to look. Can we solve the problems confronting us? Well, the answer is an unequivocal and emphatic yes. I believe we, the Americans of today, are ready to act worthy of ourselves. Ready to do what must be done to ensure happiness and liberty for ourselves, our children, and our children's children. And as we renew ourselves here in our own land, we will be seen as having greater strength throughout the world. We will again be the exemplar of freedom and a beacon of hope for those who do not now have freedom. With the idealism and fair play which are the core of our system and our strength, we can have a strong and prosperous America at peace with itself and the world. If we look to the answer as to why for so many years we achieved so much, prospered as no other people on earth, it was because here in this land we unleashed the energy and individual genius of man to a greater extent than has ever been done before. Freedom and the dignity of the individual have been more available and assured here than in any other place on earth. The price for this freedom at times has been high, but we have never been unwilling to pay that price. The crisis we're facing today does not require of us the kind of sacrifice that Martin Treptow and so many thousands of others were called upon to make. It does require, however, our best effort and our willingness to believe in ourselves and to believe in our capacity to perform great deeds, to believe that together, with God's help, we can and will resolve the problems which now confront us. And after all, why shouldn't we believe that? We are Americans. God bless you and thank you.
What is at stake is more than one small country. It is a big idea, a new world order.
Out of these troubled times, our fifth objective, a new world order, can emerge. Now we can see a new world coming into view. A world in which there is a very real prospect of a new world order.
We have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order, a world where the rule of law, not the law of the jungle, governs the conduct of nations. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order, an order...
This is no fantasy, no careless product of wild imagination.
No, my good friends, these indictments that I've brought you today, specific charges listed herein against the individuals, their acts of treason, their ultimate aim of sedition. These are matters of undeniable fact.
I ask you now to pronounce judgment on those accused. On this mindless aberration, whose only means of expression are wanton violence and destruction. Once trusted by this council, charged with maintaining the defense of the planet itself, chief architect of this intended revolution and author of this insidious plot to establish a new order amongst us, with himself as absolute ruler. You have heard the evidence. The decision of the council will now be heard.
Guilty.
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 After 1989, President Bush said, and it's a phrase that I often use myself, that we needed a new world order. A new world order. A new world, a new world, a new world order.
Is emerging.
It is a new world order with significantly different and radically new challenges for the future.
A new world order. A new world order.
It is a new world order.
A new world order.
Not just militarily, we've got to give them a stake in creating the kind of world order that I think all of us would like.
The problem of the Bush presidency will be the emergence of a new international order.
Within the next 4 years, we will see the emergence of a new international order.
The beginning of a new international order.
In this new world, will have a profound impact. The forces shaping this world at this moment are so strong, and they all tend in one direction.
World government is the structure necessary for global justice.
to establish a new order amongst us.
It is a big idea, a new world order, where diverse nations are drawn together in common cause. It is a big idea.
A new world order.
A new world order.
A new world order.
It is a big idea.
A new world order.
A new world order.
It is a new world order.
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 It is a big idea.
A new world order.
A new world order.
It is a new world order.
The heroic fight with us. The honest support us. The corrupt fear us. For we are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forget. We do not forgive. Expect us to expose you.